Well, how you doing, ladies and gentlemen? There it is, our first little fall tree of the season. It's coming. I want to address a couple things today that are on my mind. Isn't that what I always do? I shouldn't even preface it. How are you guys doing? Yeah, so first of all, I just want to talk about critics. Yeah, and I just, so for some of you this might be helpful, or you haven't considered this before, but please consider the authenticity, maybe, of your critics. Right? There's a better word for it. When I was kind of chewing it over today, some of us have critics. Many of us get criticized in life. Some of us, I suppose, have never been criticized. You sheltered folks, you're not lucky. I think dealing with criticism is important. Well, here we go, right? Let's get around this guy. I'm sure I'll be criticized for that move. So, when assessing the credibility of your critics, well, there we go, credibility, there's a better word for it, right? Do you know the person? You know, does the person have a face or a name or any credibility whatsoever? Yeah, it's kind of funny. I don't get a whole lot of negative comments. Thank you very much. I don't think we need more negativity in the world. I mean, if you know, people feel obligated to leave a negative comment, that's kind of shows where their heart is. However, I don't tend to leave negative comments, although I'll get to one that I left recently. But yeah, so in September, you know, I posted a video. Oh man, what was it even about? It wasn't the flag one, although that one got some funny kickbacks. And I think it's because some people maybe felt a little twinge of like, I think he's talking about me. And then they took umbrage to that. So, I mean, I guess that's on you. I'll accept that. I'll accept that negative commentary as long as you're taking to heart what I raised there. And some people didn't actually watch the video. They just assumed I was pontificating on something. And it struck the very thought of that struck a nerve and brought out their negativity. So again, that's your heart. So that's on you. Because we have elections that have just happened or are coming up. They're probably coming up. I'll probably actually post this super soon. Just while it's fresh in my head, and some of you guys are still riding and haven't hung it up for the season yet. Some of you guys don't need to because you live in great places. But so I was talking about just a little consideration as far as if you're struggling with how to vote, you know, who to vote for. You're on the fence and blah, blah, blah. So go watch the video if you don't know what I'm talking about. I'm not going to rehash it here, but it was very non-biased. Yeah, and so I got a little bit of commentary from people that I actually believe they were hoping I was going to commiserate with their bias, whatever that may be. I think I know what side they were on, which, like, come on, guys. Not helping your cause. But, so I think that was the case. But in that video, I had one commenter who was like, he or she, I suppose it could be, although it rang of like, you know, 13-year-old in mom's basement kind of commentary. Well, I know a lot of great 13-year-olds. I've worked with a lot of young people over the years, but you know what I'm talking about. This guy's 13, but he's actually, you know, 42. You know what I mean? I don't know what I'm talking about. So here I am being all judgmental. But the comment was about how fast I was going through a construction zone and that I'm an accident waiting to happen. And so I'm like, geesh, you know, like, I don't get a lot of criticism on my videos because I'm not that kind of channel. So I, you know, yeah, so I kind of assessed the situation. I'm like, all right, no real name, so to speak, no face, no credibility, you know? And, you know, so I just said, thanks. You know, I mean, typically in a comment like that, I'll just ignore it or try to put a positive spin on it. I do try to respond to everybody, whether it's just with a like or a something like that. I try to respond to everybody, you know, so I loved that comment. And then I just said, thanks, you know, because there's no credibility there. This is just some weird missile coming in from nowhere and landing in the comment section. Faceless, nameless, no credibility. But those kind of things, for some people, it really stings. You know what I mean? Like, some people have a hard time with criticism, especially if they're not the kind that dish it out. And actually, sometimes, especially if they are the kind that dish it out, sometimes I've seen those people get more irritable than other people. Because, you know, it's a one-way street. But yeah, what I wanted to say was, so yeah, assess the credibility of your critics. So if you have critics, they got no name, they got no face, they got no videos, they got no credibility. So just wipe it off your radar. You know what I mean? It's nothing to you. Now, if the person, you know, wants to kind of engage in a little bit of dialogue, or, you know, maybe they don't have a channel, they're afraid to put their face up, or just don't want to, and they can't use their real name because they got a name that, you know, 400 billion other people have already selected as their name. So they got some numeric thing, but perhaps they are a real person who is genuinely either concerned about something or is genuinely interested. You know, you can gauge that pretty quickly. And, you know, so in most of the time, almost every time, somebody has left a comment similarly assessing my, you know, something I've said or done, and they just disappear. No name, no face, they never respond a second time, right? Or if they do, it's like, you know, they just say the same thing they said before, or like, well, yeah, but that's not what you, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Like, not, again, not a credible rebuttal or rebuff, you know? So, but if they are, you know, credible, if they do have a genuine concern, maybe they're new to riding, new to moto vlogging, something like that, then it might be beneficial for both of you, or both of us, to engage in a little conversation. You know what I mean? And sometimes you can really gauge somebody's credibility if they reach out not publicly. You know, if they reach out through a DM or something and say, hey, you know, just wanted to let you know. You know, if they do that, that's totally acceptable. You're reaching out not for your own, you know, edification. You know, like, you're not trying to get seen or heard or something. You have a genuine thing, then that's great, that's valid. I appreciate those quite a bit. You know, so assess the credibility of your critics. If they're not credible, wipe them off your radar. But to the point, I guess, of the person who was criticizing my rate of speed through a construction zone, and that's gonna get me in an accident someday. An accident waiting to happen. You know, I would say to that, I've had a couple accidents. Yes, I have. And none of which involved my riding skills. You know, I had somebody came on the wrong side of a concrete barrier, ran me off the road, and then I got rear-ended by a nurse at a red light. The nurse was texting and ran into me. So there wasn't much I could do about that. But also, just in case you haven't moto vlogged or haven't really used a GoPro, things look different on a GoPro. If somebody pulled right out in front of me right now, it wouldn't look that close. Now, you guys know what I'm talking about. Somebody pulls out like right now, it would not look close, but it's very close. The other thing is, sometimes it appears that the rider is going faster than the rider is in fact going. And, you know, it could have something to do with, like, I don't know, the frame rate that you select, or I don't even know. Oh, by the way, I figured out today, it's a GoPro 7 that I have. And, yeah, so I don't know. Somebody asked and I couldn't remember because I got it Not used, but I got it pretty cheap. Yeah, it's a GoPro 7. It's what I've been using however long I've been doing this, which is not too long, a little over a year maybe. Yeah, so sometimes it does appear that the rider's going faster than he or she's actually going. So rest assured, nameless, faceless one, I can review the footage, but it's almost certain that I was well within the limits of responsibility whilst rocketing through the construction zone. But yeah, maybe file this away, that what happens on a GoPro doesn't always look, to other riders or whatever, it's pretty apparent, but if you haven't used a GoPro, things do sometimes look funny. And when you're on a bike, you're kind of leaning in turns and you're looking around turns. So even curvy stretches don't always look very curvy. You know what I mean? Because you're kind of eating up those curves, with leans and with head angle. So curvy situations don't always look curvy. That's why you see, like, occasionally you'll see a video, of a moto vlogger. Maybe they slide out or something. They came up on their, they rolled onto their exhaust and slid out or something happened. And, but it didn't look like, man, what is that guy's got a lean angle of 2 inches? But sometimes, honestly, it doesn't, it doesn't look like what it in reality feels like. So that could be an issue as well. So if you're out there, if you're watching this video too, even though, you're worried for my safety, maybe you're watching because you are, rest assured that sometimes it's that would be the case as well. And I just want to, just real quick, talk about when I do do a little bit of negative criticism on somebody else's show. I'll tell you who I would take criticism from. Somebody credible. If Eric from Kraken's Garage and Adventures said, hey, just want to let you know you're a little spicy through those construction zones, I would take that to heart in a second. Purple on 3, I've taken that to heart in a second, right? No questions asked. Because we have a rapport, they have a platform, they have credibility. Yeah. Anyhow, recently I did make a negative comment on somebody's channel, not a moto vlogger, this guy, he's professing to be one thing. He's got a wildly popular channel, and he's a real harsh critic on certain people who frankly do deserve harsh criticism. Now we're in the religious foray here, but yeah, it's a guy who pretty much makes a living at calling out false teachers, the guys that give God and the Bible and stuff a real bad name. He's calling a lot of those people out, and explaining why their preaching or their teaching is, it's heretical, it's super dangerous. It results in a lot of really dangerous situations, for people financially, emotionally, spiritually, whatever. And so this guy, who's normally spot on and whatever, he started a video, but he started it, by really making fun of some people in a way that was not consistent with his message, right? So it was kind of detrimental to his platform, detrimental to his arguments. And so I left a comment, hey, thanks, appreciate your videos, or blah, 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 and then I just pointed out, like, look, I don't normally do this, but here's my, some people go like, I was like, holy smokes, so are you getting upset? Is it not true? Like, this guy's, he's damaging his own platform. But some people really, they love his stuff so much that any hint of criticism send them, into wild fits of hysteria. And which is again, says more about people. But I appreciate their devotion. But yeah, when we get devoted to a human being, we gotta be careful to continue to vet that situation, because people are people, man. Everybody's got skeletons Everybody's got, you know, character defects. Everybody's got something. You just don't normally get to see them on carefully crafted, you know, social media or content posts, right? But it's there, man. Everybody's got stuff. You know, so you don't worship people, man. And, you know, if somebody criticizes somebody you love, like, for example, like if somebody criticized Tommy Heinsohn, you know, or the great Bill Russell, it would tick me off, right? Because these are two historical Boston Celtic figures that I revere quite a bit. But I would look into it. Yeah, I mean, same thing happened with John Wayne. I'm not a John Wayne fan. And, you know, my friend who's, kind of sees him as embodying all that's good in America, you know, I was like, dude, this guy, you know, anyway, he's not what you think, you know what I'm saying? That's his movie persona, which ain't all that great either, you know, for, anyway, that's a topic for another day. So yeah, consider the credibility of your critics. If you're gonna criticize, make sure you got a solid foundation and that you actually have some credibility yourself. You know, I work in the ministry, so I have a little bit of credibility there. You know, but we're all works in progress. We're all human. So, you know, just because I have credibility, I'm only gonna really open my mouth if I feel like somebody's, you know, really in error and in danger of, you know, kind of hurting themselves or somebody else. And that's it, guys. I end on a positive note. Go subscribe to Kraken's Garage and Adventures. Go subscribe to Purple on 3. These are both very edifying, wonderful moto vlog channels. Two impeccable creatures. I'm sure they have skeletons, but these are the type of people that I am certain who they are on screen is who they are in the kitchen. You know what I'm saying? And that's, I respect that about people. And in the meantime, hey, Matt the Greeter, I would hope if you meet me in real life, when you meet me in real life, I'd hope I'm the same guy you're hearing right now, you know? So I'd like to meet some of you guys at some point. We're out there. I see a lot of cameras on helmets, but not as many as I should be seeing. But anyhow, Matt the Greeter, care about you. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.